Hello and welcome to the Beyond Effect tutorial series. In this series, we're going to be talking about all the effects inside of Beyond, where you can use them, the different types of timing of effects. We're going to even go through the effects one by one, and we're going to talk about how they can be used in different scenarios that you can use them in. But first off, it's important to understand that in Beyond, we have a universal pool of effects. Now, what that means is that we have all of the effects. Wherever you can add effects, they're always going to be the same list of effects. So once you learn the list of effects, you familiarize yourself with those effects, you'll be able to use them anywhere that you think effects can be added, anywhere that effects can be added. And where they can be added is actually all over the place, whether you're in a shape and you can add effects in here, whether they are quick effects, whether they are effects that are just as cues, whether they're in the timeline, or they're even, you can find them in places like the projection zones, where you can add effects to a specific zone. So say you wanted to have a brightness or something, you could add it on there. There's a lot of awesome places you can put effects. Now, the next thing we need to learn is that there are a few different types of effects inside of Beyond. There are oscillation effects, key effects, and then there's power and control, power and color control effects. And there's also two different types of timing. So if we just open one of these, we have beat-based, which is it goes based on the global BPM, or we have time-based, which is done in seconds. So you can say, oh, it's 1 second, 2 seconds, whatever, or it can be one beat or two beat. And we're going to go into how that works at moving forward.